A story of data loss and what could have been. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Rather than starting with a question, I'm going to start with something I posted on Facebook several years ago. Just had to break the news to a friend that the photos on the hard drive that failed, the contents of which we were able to recover thanks to some hard disk utilities, turned out to be encrypted by ransomware, CryptoWall, and we had no way to decrypt them. And no, they didn't have a recent backup, and yes, there were some very important photographs there. I'm hoping that they'll be able to recover some, at least, from friends and family with whom they had shared the photos. This is why, folks, this is why I harp and harp and harp on backing up. Seriously, stuff happens. Sometimes it's benign, and sometimes it's downright heartbreaking. Please, back up. So that's what I wrote several years ago, and honestly, I keep seeing scenarios like this relatively regularly. What I want to do is walk through this scenario because it's a really good example of some things that actually really went wrong, a few things that kind of sort of went right, but how ultimately in the end, they didn't really help. I got a call from a friend. He was having a problem with his hard drive. The situation turned out to be this. The hard drive had some kind of physical failure, probably a bad sector or an area on the hard disk. The technicians he had taken it to had installed a replacement drive, which makes total sense. The technicians were unable to back up the faulty drive with their normal tools. The faulty drive contained important information that my friend wanted to recover. The next step for this particular computer service organization was to send it out to data recovery with costs quoted from $200 to $1,600. And remember, this was several years ago, so I'm sure the prices have only gone up. My friend's question was actually very simple. Did he need this, or was he being taken for a ride? He put the technician on the phone. The bottom line was that no, he probably wasn't being taken for a ride, and that yes, the situation was serious. They'd just gone beyond what the in-store technician could do, hence the need to send it out. He brought his machine to me instead. Now, like I said, the hard drive had a physical issue. So when I encounter a drive with a physical issue, one of the first things I do and did at that time was to run a tool called SpinWrite. It's been around forever. It hasn't been updated a lot lately, but especially at the time, it was the right tool for the job. It's one of those tools that will attempt very, very, very hard to recover information in damaged sectors. Unfortunately, at the time, SpinWrite didn't work. It would only go so far and then it would crash. Well, that's kind of a problem because I'm sure either the crash was due to the size of the drive, because SpinWrite had been developed years prior, or the interface, or in fact, potentially even the bad sectors on the drive. It's unclear. I ended up locating a different tool called MHDD, and it doesn't really try to fix bad sectors. It simply tries to remap them. So it's not necessarily a data recovery tool, but it is a tool that can basically bring a drive to usability once again so that you can recover what you can recover. I let MHDD do its thing, and it did a few things. It did not crash. It worked just fine. And then I immediately used Macrim Reflect to create a backup image of that failed hard drive. That way, I knew that no matter what I did, either to the image or to the drive, I would always have the other one to fall back on. After I got back into that machine and started poking around, it appeared that several of my friend's photographs, the very things he was hoping to recover, had been damaged. They weren't photographs anymore. You couldn't look at them. You couldn't open them. They would not be recognized as photographs. So I went looking, and what I found was not pretty. I stumbled across a file that basically says What happened to your file? All of your files were protected by strong encryption. What does this mean? It means the structure and data within your files have been irrevocably changed. How did this happen? You know, some malware was able to encrypt your files. What do I do? You pay the ransom. In other words, he had encountered ransomware. However, he had not yet seen this message, which leads me to believe that either the hard disk failure prevented the ransomware from completing its job, or the ransomware actually was still underway when this all happened and just simply hadn't completed its job. The bottom line was that the ransomware was there, and many of the images that he would want to recover were encrypted irrevocably. Now, to be clear, I believe the encryption, the ransomware, was totally unrelated to the hard disk failure. I mean, yeah, I suppose the ransomware could have stressed the disk a little bit more as it was encrypting everything. But the bottom line here is I don't think the two were related. The hard disk recovery was a success. But what it recovered were all of these encrypted files, which kind of, sort of, was an even worse situation. Now, I did try to find recovery tools specifically for this variant of ransomware. It's called CryptoWall. To this day, a decade later, there is no way to decrypt these files. I keep hoping that someday maybe it'll come up, or maybe someday we'll come up with stronger decryption tools that don't need the recovery key, but that seems unlikely. Nonetheless, I hold on to hope, which means I literally have held on to that hard drive. It is in the basement of my home, just in case. Now, when you take a look at the information page on CryptoWall provided by Bleeping Computer, they list a few different ways to attempt to recover. Restore from backup. Well, there was no recent backup. Some files were available on a months-old backup drive, but they did not include the files that we wanted to recover. File recovery software. Well, that didn't work because the process of recovering the contents of this drive invalidated anything that might have been recovered by, say, a tool like Recover. And many, if not most, ransomware tools these days take steps to basically make that impossible anyway. Same thing with shadow volume copies. These are the things that backup tools use to create backups of files that are in use. A lot of ransomware these days will actually take the step to invalidate these copies so that they cannot be used for recovery. And, of course, on their site, on the Bleeping Computer site, it said, well, restore the files from Dropbox. Dropbox was not being used. Same thing with OneDrive. That is a recovery possibility. These days, when you have ransomware, because these tools may notice that a large number of files were changing, but only if they were placed in OneDrive or Dropbox. And they both have recycle bins that you may have been able to recover the files from. So we were SOL, severely out of luck. The files that were encrypted remain encrypted with little to no hope for recovery, which naturally leads me to the moral of this story. What could have been? Look, stuff happens. Bad stuff happens. It just does. It doesn't have to be ransomware. It doesn't have to be hardware failure. It could be something else, or it could be all of these things. Hard disks die. Without warning, without notice, without a chance to ever recover anything on that drive. Not all failures are like that, but some are. And you don't get to choose which failure you're going to have. Malware happens. It shouldn't. In a perfect world, there would be no malware. In a perfect world, our anti-malware tools would catch 100% of all malware destined for our machines. We don't live in a perfect world. Malware happens, ransomware happens. You cannot avoid these scenarios. You can prepare for them. Here's what could have happened. The hard disk dies. You replace it. You restore the previous day's image backup, and you get on with your life. It's that simple. It really is. Or perhaps the machine is infected and all the files are encrypted on it and a ransom is demanded. You restore the machine from the previous day's backup. You're done. You get on with your life. You learn from the experience, of course, so as not to repeat whatever caused the malware to arrive in the first place. This is why I harp so much about backing up. It is the closest thing to a silver bullet when you're faced with hardware failure, malware, basically any form of data loss. It hurts me. I mean, it literally hurts when I see people who have lost large amounts of data, especially when that data is personal and precious and important and nowhere else. Do this. Remember, if it's in only one place, it's not backed up. If the hard disk you are using right now were to die instantly and without hope of recovery, would you lose anything important? If the answer is yes, you're not backing up. You are at risk of losing everything that is important on that hard drive. Please, if that scenario or any scenario like it is true, if you've got important data that exists in one and only one place, please start backing up. Do something. I've got articles on the topic throughout Ask Leo. I talk about it and write about it a lot, as my regular readers will know. But the bottom line here is that for purposes of this argument, I honestly don't care what technique you use. What I care about is that you use a technique that works for you and that causes your data, especially your most important data, to be backed up. Please. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/16844. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.